morning children, how are you? Hope you all are well. See, Nana, we are discussing the chapter Flying Kites, Flying High. In that chapter, we have discussed how all the friends are fighting with each other for a kite. Later on, one girl taught how to prepare a kite. And they prepared their own kites and they have enjoyed a lot. Regarding that, in our last session, we have discussed a few exercises. Today, children, here we have to discuss about one word, collocations. Collocations are nothing, nana. Kotta padam meeku. Collocations ante em ledu, it's a combination of two words. See, children, when we combine a two words, according to the convenience, it forms a collocation. See, collocation is nothing but the combination of words which are often used together. Suppose I tell you, slept soundly. These are the few examples of the collocations. Fully satisfied. Next example for the collocation is, children, completely forgot. Few examples. Completely forgot. Okay. And then they gave us the exercise, children, to write the correct collocation in the given blanks. Let us discuss that exercise given on page number 127. All of you, when you are listening this class, take your textbook, page number 127, children. We have to fill the given blanks with the correct collocations. Now see the first blank, children. I am sorry. I dash to inform you about today's meeting. Okay. Coming to our next blank, children, second one, the farmer dash after a long day's work. Okay. Coming to the third one given to you, children. Oh, it's you. I dash. You in that costume. Coming to the fourth one, children. He dashed to all my suggestions. He dashed to all my suggestions. Okay, children. Coming to the next fifth one, nana. They gave us she dash had done all the work on her own. Okay, nana, these are the given blanks to you on page number 127, children. Page number 127. Okay, see the first blank given to you children. I am sorry. I dash to inform you about today's. అంటే మర్చిపోయాడు ఈ రోజు మీటింగ్ గురించి చెప్పడం. సో ఐ కంప్లీట్లీ ఫర్గాట్. టు ఇన్ఫార్మ్ యూ అబౌట్ టుడేస్ మీటింగ్. ద ఫార్మర్ స్లెప్ట్ హార్డ్లీ. After a long day's work, slept soundly. After a long day's work, oh, it's you. I can't recognize. I hardly recognize. Hardly. The kashtanga gutubattagalya. Recognize you. Recognized you in this costume, in that costume. He dashed to all my suggestions. He really readily agreed. Deshapurvakangani opukunnattu. Readily agreed to all my suggestions. Coming to the fifth one. She confidently claimed that she had done all the work on her own. Okay, so in this way children, here we have completed the given collocations in a suitable blank with the correct situation which resembles with. Okay, our next topic in this chapter is direct indirect speech. What is our next topic we have to discuss? Direct indirect speech. Today just I'll give you the introduction. What is the direct, what is indirect? Okay, in our next session we will talk about the rules of the direct and indirect. Okay, let us see direct speech and indirect speech. Direct speech and indirect speech. First, what do you mean by the direct? Direct and a, when two persons talk to each other directly. Suppose we are talking, two members are talking to each other directly. The conversation, the words between the two persons are the direct speech. But when I am telling you members about any other member, that is indirect speech. Vere vaalla gurinchi manam maatladetappudu, suppose I am talking, he said that he would come tomorrow. Atanu naaku repu vastanani cheppadu ante manam vere vaalla gurinchi indirect speech. Okay, direct ante the actual words of the speaker. Direct means actual words of the speaker spoken by him. Actual words of the speaker. Actual words of the speaker spoken. Actual words of the speaker spoken. But these are the words which are indirectly informed by any other person about the speaker. Okay, words which are indirectly అర్థమైందా He said he will come tomorrow. అతను రేపు వస్తానని చెప్పాడు. Okay, he said I will come tomorrow. He said I will come tomorrow. But here, when indirect speech, when I am talking that he said that he would come tomorrow. అతను ఏం చెప్పాడంటే అతను రేపు వస్తానని చెప్పాడు. ఆ అబ్బాయి చెప్పేటప్పుడు నేను రేపు వస్తా అన్నాడు. Okay, so the actual words of the speaker itself is known as the direct speech, and the words which has been talked about the people using their own speech are known as indirect speech. Here two definitions has been given to us in our textbook. Nana, before to conclude, let us see the definitions written here. When we report a statement in the exact words of the speaker, atanu edaithe cheppado adi, that is known as a direct. Suppose Meeta replied gently, I know how to make a kite. When we talk about what people have said using our own words, we call this indirect speech. Meeta replied gently that she knew how to make a kite. Ante vaadu cheppe words, oka speaker cheppe words own ga cheppedi. Atanu padalni manam direct antamu. Atanu cheppe maatalni mana maatallo cheppadanni indirect speech antamu. Is it clear, children? The actual words spoken by the speaker is known as the direct speech, but the words are words which intimates the speaker's action. They are known as that is known as indirect speech. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss about the rules how to change direct to direct. Okay, once you revise today, read about the collocations also. Have a nice day.